Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Unreal Engine 5.3 was just released the other day, and in this video we're going to touch up on some of the new features and updates that are included inside of Unreal Engine 5.3, so let's go ahead and get started. Unreal Engine 5.3 marks a significant leap forward in empowering creators and developers with an array of enhancements to the core features of the engine. In addition, it introduces experimental tools that promise to redefine what's possible within the Unreal Editor. First up, let's talk about Nanite. In Unreal Engine 5.3, there's a new experimental feature that's set to revolutionize level and environment design, introducing the Nanite Spline Mesh component, a game changer for manipulating meshes in your scenes, especially when crafting intricate elements like roads. With this experimental feature, Nanite can now be enabled on these spline meshes, opening up endless creative possibilities. But that is not all for Nanite. In Unreal Engine 5.3, it brings a significant performance enhancements for Nanite masked foliage. We're talking about a whopping 20% boost in speed for the rasterization of masked Nanite foliage. This means that your environments will look more lush and detailed without sacrificing performance. Now, before we get any further on into the video, I want to quickly tell you about today's video sponsor, which are actually my courses. If you want to learn Unreal Engine 5, check out my premium courses on smartpoly.teachable.com. I currently only have one course, but it is a complete multiplayer survival game course that has over 70 hours of course content. There are over 20 different chapters walking you through how to make a multiplayer survival game from scratch. We create things like a drag and drop inventory system, a complete crafting system, a harvesting system. We also add things like a building system where you can build your own bases and structures. There's even a clan system where you can invite your friends and raid other players' bases. It's all set up with Steam servers, and I show you guys how to package the game and deploy the servers so your friends can join over the internet. There is so much content in this course, and I'm going to be raising the price of the course pretty soon. Also, I will be creating more Unreal Engine courses, things like how to create realistic environments and more other types of games. So check them all out on smartpoly.teachable.com. And with that being said, let's get right back into the video. Now let's go ahead and move on to another exciting update. Illumin, the dynamic global illumination solution, is getting even better in Unreal Engine 5.3. Illumin Reflections now supports multiple bounces when hardware ray tracing is enabled and your max reflection bounces in the post-process volume is set to 2 or higher. So say goodbye to those pesky black spots in Reflections when your performance budget allows for it. But here's the real game changer. Illumin Reflections can now be utilized independently of Illumin Global Illumination. This means that games and applications using static lighting can take advantage and achieve top tier reflection quality beyond reflection captures. It's all about flexibility and performance optimization. Now for all of you film enthusiasts out there, Unreal Engine 5.3 has a lot in store for you too. The Path Tracer is getting a major facelift and now supports heterogeneous volumes like smoke, fire, clouds, all of which you can create using Niagara. This means that your scenes will have even more realistic and captivating effects. Now let's start with sparse volume textures, a game changer in the realm of dynamic simulations. With Unreal Engine 5.3, you can effortlessly store and replay volumetric simulation data, allowing you to create stunning effects such as realistic smoke and fire. This means that your projects can now breathe with life as you harness the power of dynamic simulations right at your fingertips. What's more is the versatility of sparse volume textures extends to the seamless integrations of simulations created in other 3D applications, thanks to the ability to import OpenVDB files. This opens up endless possibilities for creating intricate, real-time visual effects that captivate and immerse your audience. There's even more innovation on the horizon. Unreal Engine 5.3 introduces a brand new experimental skeletal editor, a powerhouse of tools designed to revolutionize character animation. With this editor, you can gain precise control over your skeletal meshes, from meticulously painting skin weights to fine-tuning every detail of your character's movement. You're now in the director's chair of your character animations. Your characters will move with newfound realism and expressiveness, bringing your virtual worlds to life in ways that were previously unimaginable. For those who seek realism and aesthetics in their projects, Unreal Engine 5.3 presents the new panel cloth editor, an absolute game changer for cloth simulations. This advanced tool set empowers you to create incredibly lifelike cloth behavior with remarkable ease, but that is not all. It also includes a non-destructive cloth simulation workflow, allowing you to strike the perfect balance between speed and precision, and the ML Deformer takes your cloth simulations to the next level by enabling in-engine simulation and caching, bringing your new dimension of realism to clothing, flags, banners, and more. Whether you're designing for a wardrobe, for cutting-edge game character, or choreographing cloth movements in cinematic masterpiece, Unreal Engine 5.3 cloth simulation tools will exceed your expectations, offering boundless creativity and realism. Now, for those pioneering the world of virtual production, Unreal Engine 5.3 introduces experimental support for SimTree-ST, a critical step forward in the evolution of LED production stages. This innovation sets the stage for a future where dedicated machines for each camera maximize rendering resolution, frame rates, and scene complexity. Imagine a virtual production environment where your creative vision knows no bounds. Possibilities are limitless, from intricate scenes of breathtaking visual storytelling, all in real time. And for filmmakers among us, they have the new Cinematic Cam Rig Rail. This feature is the gateway to emulating traditional camera movements with precision. Whether you're capturing shots along tracks or orchestrating dollies, you have complete control. Choreograph camera settings at various control points along the path. Support for both in-editor and VCam workflows. It's a toolkit designed to help you achieve cinematic perfection with ease, from dynamic chase scenes to poignant character movements. Your storytelling capabilities have just taken a cinematic leap forward. Now, Unreal Engine 5.3 enhances your virtual cinematography experience. Now you can effortlessly browse takes directly on your iPad for review or re-recording. Stream different outputs to team members simultaneously or enhance collaboration. Plus, you can capture fast-paced action with ease by recording at a slower frame rate, ensuring that you never miss a moment of dynamic visual storytelling. Last but not least, Unreal Engine 5.3 elevates your content cooking capabilities by leveraging additional CPU and memory resources. Content preparation becomes quicker and more efficient than ever before. This means that you can dedicate more time to nurturing your creative vision, knowing that the engine's processing power has your back. And speaking of realism, substrate materials are now fully compatible with the Path Tracer in Unreal Engine 5.3. Now, these substrate materials are part of Unreal Engine's new layered material system. They can now seamlessly be integrated into your projects, and Unreal Engine 5.3 keeps pushing the boundaries of what's possible with real-time rendering. Now, let's dive into the updates for substrate materials. The experimental material system in Unreal Engine 5.3. Substrate, in essence, is a new layered material system, adding depth and complexity to your creations. And in Unreal Engine 5.3, Substrate is receiving some noteworthy enhancements, from glints and specular profile features, ideal for automotive applications, to improved debuffer shading node support, and even a brand new fuzz model for high-spec platforms. But that is not all. Expect updates to the Substrate Material Editor tab, along with numerous bug fixes and performance improvements. Now, Unreal Engine 5.3 is all about elevating your world-building game. Now you can enable Nanite in landscape actors, aligning it with regular landscape rendering. Nanite landscape meshes are rebuilt in the background to ensure a seamless user workflow, while also boosting runtime performance through GPU culling, automatic geometry streaming, and LODs. But that's not where all the world-building updates end. Unreal Engine 5.3 introduces support for large landscape import and export operations. The import and export process has been reamped to handle massive landscapes and resolutions effectively, thanks to the power of world partition. This means that you can bring your expansive world designs to life with ease. These are just some of the highlights awaiting you inside of Unreal Engine 5.3. To embark on this creative journey, you can discover even more if you want to visit the release notes page. You'll find a link in the description below. And of course, if you want, you can find Unreal Engine 5.3 via the Epic Games Launcher. And yeah, that is going to be it for this video. So hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like and consider subscribing. I'm trying to hit 100,000 subscribers before the end of 2023. And yeah, that is it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.